The loss function is how we calculate the error. So, of course, you can just say, I'm going to calculate it as prediction minus actual value, but you can have different ways of calculating this. And also, of course, this would only work for the regression, right? So I'm sure if you worked with machine learning before or any type of statistics, you're already familiar with some of the calculating or error calculations, loss functions, mean squared error, mean absolute error are for the regression problem. So these are things that we already used before. We can use binary cross entropy if you have a binary problem or if you have a more multi-class problem like we had in our exercise, then you will use something like sparse categorical cross entropy. There are, of course, many others. I will have a more detailed list in the summary of the class. And also, I will give you some links to other useful resources and documentation where you can find out the best loss function for your problem or for your network that you're building. Next one is the one that I'm like my favorite, basically, optimization algorithm and the learning rate. So choosing an optimizer is something that's going to be critical for your neural network. We're going to see more details on how and why and what problem it solves later. But as I said in the first slide of what it does, it basically tells us how to update the weights and biases, in which direction. Should I increase this one or should I decrease this one? What should I do with it? The one that we saw, the one that we used before in the exercise, was the gradient descent one. And that's basically nearly more or less how what everyone uses, but there are other ones. So SGD is the gradient descent one. There is a better one called RMS prop or ADAM or some other ones, but we will talk more about which one to choose in what condition in the coming lessons because a lot of details there. So you remember how the gradient descent works maybe from the previous lesson. What happens is the backpropagation calculates how much a parameter contributes or how much a parameter contributes to the error. So then we will have a graphic like this. It will tell us, okay, this is how the parameter and the error are connected or related to each other. So then gradient descent calculates the slope of this graphic, of this line, and then we know in which direction to go. So we'll go further and further until we find a minimum value. But of course, this is done for all the parameters at the same time. And how much we go here, the steps that we take are determined by the learning rate. So the learning rate can be many things. We will again talk about how to change the learning rate and how to set it up. It's normally ranges from 0.001 to, or maybe 0.0001 to 0.1. So 0.1 would be a big learning rate. But we'll talk about how to set the learning rate or even how to learn the learning rate. And there are some algorithms to dynamically change the learning rate to tackle some of the problems we have with neural networks. Some quick problems that you might have, if you set a very big learning rate, what might happen is you keep overshooting the minimum. So maybe this is where you were, and this is the minimum. If you set the learning rate to be very, very high, maybe if you only set it to be like half that, or maybe like one third of that, you would have ended up very close to the minimum. But if you set it very high, maybe the gradient descent is going to say, well, you have to go this in this direction. And you're going to say, okay, I'm going to go in this direction. The learning rate is very high, so you're going to end up on the other side. And then same thing again, and the same thing again, same thing again. And you might just end up constantly overshooting the minimum and never reaching it. Another problem could be that you set it way, way, way too low. And then what's going to happen is that you're not going to make progress very fast. You're going to go slower and slower and slower and slower, and that's going to create problems. But of course, there are, again, as I said, there are ways to solve this based on the optimization algorithm, how it behaves, but also how to update and change the learning rate to deal with this.